Hello, my name is Andrey Azarov, I am CTO of Anisoprint, and today I will show you how to print simple plastic part with Aura. First thing to do is to open your model. You can use STL or STEP format for your model, and here is our model. If you double click on the model, you will see buttons that will help you to translate, rotate, or scale your part. Let's rotate the part and scale it to 120%, for example. So now I'm rotating the part, and next step is to scale it. Here is the result. By the way, you can manipulate your view with middle mouse button, shift button, and control button. On the right side, you can see panel with settings of Aura that you need to print the part. Settings in Aura are divided into three main parts. First part is printer settings. So first we need to choose which printer we want to use for this print, and the build plate on the screen will change as well with the printer. We will use Composer A4 printer to make this part. Under the printer, you can see a list of extruders that are available on this machine, and we need to specify material for each extruder. So let's choose PETG plastic. And also here we can specify fiber, but we won't use it for this print. Third part is profile. Aura comes with a set of predefined profiles for different materials, and their number will grow in future. You can choose any of them, or you can set up your own profile with more than 200 settings. Under this list, you can see basic settings of the part. Here, for example, you can choose to turn on or turn off fiber, to choose how many plastic perimeters we want to use. Aura use macro layers technology that allows you to print external plastic shell with lower layer thickness to make print better and print surface better. And inner perimeters and infills can be printed with higher layer thickness to make the print faster. Here also you can specify infill density. You can choose higher values to make your part stronger, or you can choose smaller values to make your part lightweight and to print faster. Also, it's usually advised to turn on brim, which helps your part to stick to the build plate better. If your part has some overhangs, you can also turn on supports, but for this part we don't need supports. Next, we can press generate, and after the generation will be finished, we will see print time and material consumption on the screen. Let's look at the result. So here we can see geometry of the part, or I can switch to code mode to look at all movements, including travel movements during the print. It's also usually convenient to look at the layup layer by layer, to look at all the part internal structure. So here we can see plastic perimeters and plastic infills as well. The last step is to save the file, and after that you can copy this file to your SD card and use in your printer. Thank you for your attention, and bye.